120 passengers flown to Frankfurt on a military plane from Wuhan. That's the Chinese city at the center of the outbreak. The evacuees are now in quarantine in a medical facility. They will be there for 2 weeks. The infected are two German citizens. They are being treated in a hospital in Frankfurt where doctors say they are doing well.
Anything that's preserved, have a long shelf life, and can be stored, have all been taken by having taken a lot. It's like I said, just showing everyone just stocking up. I think we're all.
CNBC brought in Kevin Rudd, the former Australian guy who's now the head of policy at the Asian Society. And he starts off, and he says, yes, the Americans, this is very important, but I'd really like to compliment President Xi, who has been, he said, SARS took 3 or 4 months. He said, SARS took 3 or 4 months to actually, for them to take responsibility and bring it forward. This was immediate. As soon as it became evident last week, they took ownership. That is an outright lie. And I said, he knows better. This is from the first week of December. Dr. Hadfield, in the first hour of this, walked through how December and January made it that you're not going to get your hands around these things right now in China. The Chinese people are the victims, and they're the victims of the CCP. And I have a guy like the former Australian Kevin Rudd and the rest of these elites kowtow to the Chinese Communist Party and to lie. Rudd, that was a bald-faced lie. You sat there with an audience that's just getting up to speed and says, oh, well, Kevin Rudd's a pretty important guy. He says, they're so amazing. They've done such a tremendous job. It's such great transparency. They took responsibility of this and came out right away. Dude, it was 2 months and they knew it. You're a stone cold liar. And the problem that the CCP has become a global problem. And when you at home, when this virus hits you economically, and hopefully it'll never hit you health-wise, remember, this is because of the leadership of the Chinese Communist Party and the people and the elites that have kowtowed to them and kept them in power in the West. Thank you.
给那个那谁家名字打电话，对，到记者了。给别的姐，
我们错了。我跟你说，其实我们马院长啊，
学校都看你家，你知道吗？你知道吗？你家孩子你全得去举报了。
你老百姓举报到了，你知道吗？
不是，自己。
给那个孩子打电话，
错了。
马上来，你们仨等会儿，等他们来。
那你这勾拘留了，你这不用说了，勾拘留了。
这不能都不是同学吗？
哎呦我天哪，你这咋样太大了，谁都不行，谁都不行啊。给那个电影打电话，让抓紧派记者来，完了全县给我们通报。大姐，
行，我们监控了全县让我们现在生活，你知道吗？
你知道啥情况吗？你我们责任多大，你知道吗？
错了，全县就围着家饭店，我都看你家这样，我不羡慕罢了吗？
都是。
温州地府老乡亲。
只要还有一粒米，不往人多的地方挤。只要还有一滴油，待在屋里不露头。只要还有一根葱，不往菜市场里面冲。只要还有一口气，待在家里守整天。 上班是负担，温饱是祸害，谨遵守规矩，自己爱自己。我在家，我骄傲，我为祖国争口罩。
你的羊呢？那放下来个桶也整过，你把那个杀鸡，连的一连的药剂，好吧？你把那个子找给呢？
哦，大家看一下啊，都是来排队的，对吧？那边，有，那我想大家都是来买口罩的，你们都是买口罩的，对吧？啊，好。 大家看一下啊，整个队伍大概排了有300米。那么目前呢，就是我们大家响应国家的整个号召，希望大家在家里不要出去。那么实际上大家看一下，目前的情况下，大概有350到400个人都在这边，大家这样排队。那像我这样在又在咳嗽的人，对吧？都没有口罩，那么只能来排队买口罩。那么这个你说？ 对本身对整个病毒的一个传染都是不利的，对吧？大家没有办法。那么既然市政府，我觉得办的好事，完全可以落实到街道或者居委会，那由居委会组织专门人每家每户上门去送。那我愿意做这样一个义务工作者，对吧？那我相信大部分都是愿意的。那目前一方面在叫大家不要出门，一方面就在。 让那么多人过来排队来买口罩，那么这个对病毒的一个传播，大家说有没有好处？那我只是把这个视频拍下来传到网上，我希望有更好的方法来解决这个病毒的传播，对吧？那么很多人都没有戴口罩，大家想一下啊，就我知道全市大概有500到1000个网点，那么那么多人聚集在这样一个。 这样一个场所来买这个口罩，好啊！我今天过来就是做这个事情。我希望更多的人能看到这个视频，希望把口罩落实到居委会，由居委会或者是每个街道派专门的人员派发。那我愿意做这个一个义务工作者，好吧？那个我希望大家。 大家有机会的话多配合一下，好吧？因为尽量少出门，那为了健康嘛，对吧？
各位。
这里就是火神山，我们可以来看一下，这里的条件都还是相当不错的，看见没？两个人一个房间，而且我们的后面全都是各种各样的设备，就是吸氧的，还有你看我手上现在在做的这个是氧饱和，然后还有给我量血压，那边旁边就是监控的设备都在旁边，然后上面有空调、空气净化器，然后还有上方的各种空气系统，当然这边还有电视，不过现在还没有用。那边还有一个洗手间，这看起来也是不错的。我觉得这边的条件真的好好，远远的超过我们的想象，甚至进来的时候每个人都发了病号服，都换上病号服，我们在室内医院住院的时候都没有，甚至细心的拖鞋都是全新的，都准备好了，什么东西都是全套的。我们今天刚刚才到这里，还没开始进行治疗，稍后还会继续跟大家来通报。
真的没事。
But this, as we now know, came roaring out of China. And this is what upsets me so much about the signing of the trade deal, phase one. I think it's a 25 or 30 man contingent from China. Did they give anybody a heads up about how bad this was? Because the Chinese government, the CCP, definitely knew it. Okay, we got to be very blunt about that. We have to hold people accountable, not like the WHO.